Yeah, it sure is. With a national outcry, though, and calls for an assault weapons ban, a lot of people have been waiting to see where the NRA would go on this one. But for those who were looking for any kind of self-reflection from the lobbying power, that didn't happen. Instead, the group blamed violent video games and movies, and especially the media.
I can imagine the headlines, the shocking headlines you'll print tomorrow. More guns, you'll claim, are the NRA's answer to everything.
Accusing the media of lying and demonizing gun owners, the NRA on Friday didn't talk about any kind of gun control, instead putting forth a suggestion that the solution can be found by putting an armed police officer in every school by early next year.
The only thing that stops a bad guy with a gun is a good guy with a gun.
I think we need to think of other options rather than suggesting that we put more guns in school.
On a day Manchester school superintendent Tom Brennan toured schools to address rumors of threats and answer questions, he says in talking to educators he's found there isn't much of an appetite for armed guards in the classroom or for teachers to be armed themselves.
To the contrary, I believe I've heard people say, I don't want a weapon. I don't want that responsibility.
But for some parents who are obviously thinking about the safety of their child, the idea does have merit.
I feel like it would, I don't know, give me a little bit of comfort and maybe deter some people from trying to get into the schools. Probably not all of them, but at least it's something.
Others believe it can't be that simple.
I think you have to do something, and maybe that's enough for now, but I think you have to do more.
All right, back to that NRA press conference. Despite a controlled setting today, the press conference was interrupted twice by protesters. You can see in the video behind me. Both times a person was removed from the room, though, and no charges were filed. Reporting live, Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.